Would you like a free tool to extract data from PDF to Excel? There are PDF Excel converters that can get the task done. You can also use copy and paste if you don't have a lot of data. Now, Power Query has a new feature where you can import data from a PDF document. But does it really work though? Does your imported information update when the content of the PDF document changes and you refresh your data? Let's find out. We're going to take a look at three different examples to see if we can successfully import our data from PDF to Excel. In the first example, I have the safety report, and on the second page, I have the safety performance data. So let's say I get this from the safety department. I need to grab this table and put it in my Excel file so I can do further analysis on this. Well, my first try would be to just copy and paste this. I'm just going to highlight, press Ctrl C to copy, go to Excel and press Ctrl V. Now this brings over the information, but it loses all the formatting. So if I had the time, I can organize this into a table again. But unfortunately, I don't have the time. So this is what I'm going to do instead. Go to Data, Get Data, From File, From PDF. I want my safety data, click on Import. In the Navigator view, I get to select what part of the PDF document I want to import. If it recognizes any tables, it's going to show it to me as table. On the bottom below the tables, you're going to see the content of the page. So that can be a table, but together with everything else that's on that page. So notice on page 2 where I had my table, in the page view here, I also see the page numbers. So in this case, since I just want the table information, I'm going to go with the table view, click on Transform Data, just to make sure everything looks good. I have headers here. This one is missing. Let's also give this report a name. Everything else looks good. Let's send this to our Excel sheet. I want it as a table, and I want it on the existing worksheet. And I get my table in the proper structure. I can update the formatting of this. I can use this to create pivot tables or use formulas to do further analysis. Now we also want to check whether this is dynamic. So let's say I receive new information. That information is in another PDF document. It has the same name, it's called Safety Data, but this time it also includes 2020 information. So I'm just going to drag it and drop it into my drive. I'm going to replace the file in the destination. So now let's go back to our report, right mouse click and refresh this to see if we pull over the new information. And our 2020 information comes in automatically. So we've created a connection to our PDF document. And as long as the structure of our PDF document doesn't change, everything remains dynamic. In the second example, I have this report from the Tesla webpage. It's their Q2 2020 financial update. Now let's say I'm interested in grabbing this table, which is on page 4, and I want to bring it to Excel. So here I can see their quarterly financial information. As a first try, let's just try to copy this. So Control C, go to Excel, and let's do Control V and see if it works this time. Unfortunately, it doesn't work. It's going to be very difficult to work with this data. So instead, let's go to Data, Get Data, From File, From PDF. That's my PDF. Let's import. This time I get a lot of tables and a lot of pages. That's the number of pages I have in my PDF file. Now, whenever you can, just work with the table view. This way you can avoid all the other information that's on the page. So the table I wanted was on page 4. Now, it doesn't look so great anymore. So the quarterly information is here, but it looks like my first column, the text column, was split into multiple columns. So let's take a look at whether we can easily transform this to get what we want. it's recognized that these are number columns, so it's formatted them as decimal type. These last two, they're formatted as text because they have a mix of numbers and text. So if I want to, I can clean these up, or I can get rid of them completely if I don't want them in my report, or I can just keep them as they are. Now I'll just leave the rest as is, but what I want to clean up are these columns here. I want to get them to just become one column. So I'm going to highlight the first column, hold down the shift key, highlight this column 5 here. Now let's just merge these. Right mouse click, merge columns. My delimiter should be a space, call this dollar in millions aside from percentage values. This is something similar they had in their report, dollar millions except percentages and per share data. Okay, so I'll just keep it like that, click on OK, and now we have one column. When you use transform to merge columns, you get this additional spaces in your merged column. Now you don't get that if we add a column and merge these together, but it's no problem. What I can do is just to trim this. Right mouse click, transform, trim, and we get rid of these extra spaces. What I'm also going to do is get rid of these blanks. So let's go ahead and filter these out. Now here's something interesting. Notice the negative numbers here. Let's take a look at our PDF report. The negative numbers are in brackets. So Power Query recognized these as negative numbers instead of putting them as text, which is great because it saves us a lot of additional steps. My report is done. Let's give this query a name and let's send this to the workbook. Close and load. And we've successfully brought the table from the PDF document to our Excel file. In the third example, I want to do something different. I want to grab the table of contents from a manual. Now, this manual has over 200 pages, and the table of contents starts on page 3 and goes to page 5. This is the part of the manual I want to grab and put into Excel. So let's see how we can do that. Let's go to our Excel. Go back to the Data tab, get Data from File, from PDF. That's my manual, let's import it. Now the bigger the PDF file, the longer it's going to take for it to analyze it, but check this out, even though this has over 200 pages, it has a lot of tables, it doesn't take that long. It's already assessed where it has tables, and down here we can see the contents of all the pages. My table of contents was on page 3, so it's recognized it as a table. Then page 4 and page 5 was the rest. So these are the three that I want to import. Now I have the option to select multiple items, but when I do it this way, it's going to create a separate query for each of these, and then I can append these. Now instead of doing it this way, I'm going to select the folder, right mouse click, and transform the data. This way I can do the appending with one click. What I want are tables. So this was what I wanted, then it was this and this. Kind for these is table. So let's add a filter and just take a look at our tables. Now I have my table of contents right here. These are in the first 3 rows. So let's go and keep the top rows and put a 3 here and okay. Now, when I click to the side here, I can see the content of each of these. What I don't need anymore are these 3. I'm going to highlight and delete and now expand my data. Let's click on OK and I get my table of contents appended together. Now I can clean this as I want. Let's say I don't need these null values here where I have the section number and the section name, so I can filter these out. What I can also do is create a separate column for my numbering here. The delimiter to use for this can be this right here, but notice I have it multiple times for some of the topics. This means I need to be careful and not apply this delimiter for each time. So let's select the column, split column by delimiter. I wanted custom and I copied it before, so I'm going to paste it in. Now I'm also going to add a space before and after because that's what I have in each field. So here's the change I need to make. I don't want each occurrence of the delimiter. I want the leftmost delimiter and click on OK. So now I have my numbers separately. Let's give this the proper name. This is topic and these are my page numbers. Let's also update the formatting. So this should be a whole number. This is text and that's a decimal number. Everything else looks good. Let's send this to Excel. I want it as a table. Let's put it in A1 and OK. It's loading everything right here. And I have my table of contents together with the page numbers. So these are the different ways you can import data from your PDF documents into Excel. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit that thumbs up. And if you aren't subscribed to this channel, consider subscribing before you leave. And I'm going to see you in the next video.